أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، ونصلي ونسلم على سيد الأنبياء والمرسلين سيدنا محمد، اللهم صلي وسلم وبارك عليه. My dear sister, my dear brother, my dear viewer, my dear listener, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. الحمد لله. I am back, and today I like, as I have done before, to bring to you the latest medical health social study, which came in the last 7 days. I bring usually these studies are educational to us, very useful. Second reason, many of these studies prove some Islamic belief or concept in Quran or Sunnah, etc. But before going into this main subject about medical and social study, allow me to go to a few announcements. As you know, we are now almost in the middle of the month of Rajab. Rajab, then Sha'ban, then Ramadan in early July. Ramadan. So I thought I will remind you of the importance, briefly, importance of this holy month, Rajab, then holy month, obviously will be Sha'ban to talk about it, and the biggest holy month will be Ramadan, as you know. The Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, he used to do dua in this month. اللهم بارك لنا في رجب وشعبان وبلغنا رمضان. May Allah bless this month, Rajab, and the months coming after Sha'ban, وَبَلِّغْنَا رَمَضَان, and give us the opportunity to do fasting months of Ramadan. Give us a chance not to die or miss this great month of Ramadan. Maybe in about week's time, as you know, 26, Rajab, you know the famous story in Islam, in the Quran, in Ahadith, Al-Isra wal-Mi'raj. Remember that. They say 9:26 of Rajab. It's very important to remember this night, to talk about it in mosques, to explain it to our children, the miracle, Isra wal-Mi'raj. Allah takes the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم in Mecca to Masjid al-Aqsa, Jerusalem. There he pray, behind him all Prophet. Then Allah took him up in heaven, seven heaven. And big story what he saw in every heaven. So please, my dear brother and sister, remember this important night, which could be in about a week time, I think. Or a little more, you know, Al-Isra, you know, Allah journey taken, Allah taken Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam from Mecca till Masjid al-Aqsa, then ascension in heaven. And here a reminder to all Muslims in the world, Masjid al-Aqsa, Al-Quds, Jerusalem. This Masjid Aqsa was the first Qibla. Instead of going to Mecca, we used to go to, when we pray, to Masjid Al-Aqsa. It's so holy place. And mentions the Quran, Allah barakna hawla. Allah bless all the land around, you know, this Masjid Al-Aqsa. What we see commonly on TV and activity and poster, Dome of the Rock. This is not Masjid Al-Aqsa. On the side, you will see the mosque, called Masjid Al-Aqsa, but the whole land area, they call it Al-Aqsa or Masjid Al-Aqsa. But commonly we saw the Dome of the Rock, and here the rock and ascension of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam to heaven. So we should remember Masjid Al-Aqsa belong to Muslim. Muslim should be free to go there to pray, and highly recommended. First Hajj, second to go pilgrimage. to go to visit Masjid al-Aqsa. And this Masjid al-Aqsa, this area, holy area, should not be occupied, should not be controlled by anybody, whether Israeli or other, should be left to the Muslim. We know there are holy places around it for Jew or Christian or other. No problem. You have all your holy place. So all this area, in fact, land should be open to all and not controlled by anybody. Now, my second point, I have to mention it here. We all have been shocked, no doubt. Muslim and non-Muslim and Christian, about this Wallish attack, killing of this soldier in Wallish in South London last Wednesday. Obviously, all Muslim organizations have condemned this attack, unfortunately, by a Muslim or convert or Nigerian convert Muslim. This is not Islamic as we know. This is not the place to kill civilian or soldier walking on the road. If you have something to do, go to the battle in Afghanistan or Iraq or any other area, but not in this land where we have covenant of security and peace and saving life for all of us and no attack on any one of us. So this was very bad. And as you know, we have very, 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 very small minority and few of them, they talk on television, they do act. It damaged all British Muslims, 3 million, and give bad impression on Islam and Muslim. We need to be careful about this, and we need really to have internal discussion, argument with all these few small, they call them extremists, etc. But I have to confess here, there is no doubt, as we've seen in this attack and 7 July before, etc., the foreign policy of Britain should be addressed. We should not deny it. As many as the government deny it, even Muslim deny it. This is a motive, but not, it's not justified. Whatever the reason of foreign policy is not justified to kill any innocent civilian in Britain or any country walking on the road. This is not a battle here. And they're giving you facility, you're living in their land, you know, in a way, and they're giving a lot of benefit, etc. But there is a case which came by the man who done the killing last Wednesday and by other before him, bad foreign policy. British American occupying Muslim land, killing Muslim women and children, etc. We have a big disaster before in Iraq. We're still having big, also less than before disaster in Afghanistan. This issue should not be put under the carpet. It should be addressed. But not in this way, in this horrible way, in this bad, un-Islamic way, to kill, slaughter a soldier on the road, etc. But we need to address, we have two jobs to do, in fact, Muslim in Britain or Europe, Muslim minority everywhere, to address in the democratic way, in the English way, this bad foreign policy, no doubt about it. And we need to work on this few young, many of them adolescent, young Muslim, who go so extreme in their view, in their attitude. We need to talk to them. We need to educate them. We need to contain them. Because just as you know, one Muslim has damaged now 3 million British Muslim. And not only that, this is a big worry now, and I hope I'm wrong, it might get worse. Till now, about 163 attack on mosque. This morning I was watching attack, mosque burn, fire in Grisby. You know, this is a backlash. And many people do not know, any Muslim should be aware what he's doing. You know, 163, they say 9 mosque attack. And it's going to get worse. And I hope I'm wrong, you know. And we have to remember, you see, my dear Muslim brother and sister, a lot of people on the road, non-Muslim, English, Christian by name, etc. They drink alcohol. Daily, evening, weekend. Alcohol inflame, عداوة, بغضاء, enmity, hate. We cannot control that. So you will be more likely, if you Muslim sister walking on the road, be careful, please. We have a lot of attack on sisters. Pulling hijab, pulling clothes is happening now in Britain, in many areas. Please, sister, don't go out alone at night. Please, brother, don't go out alone at night. You know, and during the day, no Muslim should be alone in an area or near the pub, etc. And you have to be careful. If you dress looking Islamic, you'll be a target. We're not saying all, but there will be target on sister, alone, at night, on old man, brother. You know, you have to be careful. You know, forgive me for saying that. The way you look Islamically, it attracts the attack. If you're wearing, you know, the Islamic Somalian clothes, the Islamic Pakistani clothes, man or woman, and hijab, you will be more attacked. So maybe in a wise way, you should avoid dressing too much, looking Islamic as such, you know. And mosque in Britain and everywhere, they should get the police advice how to protect the mosque. There are facility, easy facility, free advice from crime, from burglary, from fire. They should study. They call it risk assessment. Not only that, I remember now, you have to watch when you have letterbox for, you know, the post to go inside your house, letterbox. Postman, put it. Some people might use fire. Be careful. It happened in a good day before. We didn't have this problem. Some Muslim house burned. Family died from fire. Muslim family. It happened before. This letterbox is an easy target to put something with light, with fire, you know, to go inside to burn the whole house. So I want you to be aware. I don't want to scare you too much, but this is a reality. You need to protect the entrance to your house, to especially the letterbox, and not to be alone at all. You want to go jama'ah with people, with Muslim together. Don't go alone. And don't be alone at night walking on the road. You know, it's very sensitive, very dangerous time now. My dear Muslim brother and sister, we need to take precaution, protect our sister especially. You know, if you can help it, don't go out, please, my dear sister, if you can manage. You know, and don't, I think the biggest target will be niqab. Any sister wearing niqab on the road, she will be possible to be attacked, etc. Because these people are very upset, and I don't blame them to get upset, but obviously I blame them to use this wrong way to damage 3 million Muslims because of one. What did we do? You know, once I used to have the Irish, you know, coming, doing bomb here in Britain from Northern Ireland. Did they go and attack all the Irish, Christian, Catholic? Never. You don't attack the whole community. They didn't burn church there. They didn't kill people there, you know, because of attack of terrorists. There have been many terrorists attacked by the Irish in Northern Ireland, you know, coming to Britain. Have you forgotten the big attack on the guard and police in Hyde Park with the horse? 3 horses, I think, died in this barbaric terrorist attack. So this is very wrong attitude from every British, from every non-Muslim, from every Christian. You don't destroy the whole community because of one mistake done by someone. Deal with the one who done the crime. Because we Muslim, by and large, and all of us almost, we love to live in peace in this country. But we should ask for our right, human right, and defend the Muslim land by the Western democratic way. To lobby parliament, to picket 10 Downing Street. There are so many ways to deal, but not this walking innocent soldier, you know, cut his throat or, you know, and kill him just like that. This is the worst impression, bad impression on Islam and Muslim I ever seen in the last 40 years also. This is the worst. The worst and the bad publicity. And unfortunately, the television making it worse. Newspapers, they're making it worse. These dangerous Muslims in Britain. We are law-abiding citizens. We are family-minded. We work, you know, we take care. We have a lot of value, moral value, and a lot of family value. And you don't see that Muslim in any city going to attack or kill anyone. So I hope the British, the non-Muslim, use their mind and brain, you know, and not to destroy and keep going from mosque to mosque to attack. In the mosque, we teach peace. The attack in this mosque, and many mosques now, 9 or 10, we give Friday khutbah and we give talk after talk to live in peace and harmony, not to hurt anyone. You know the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, I never forget this hadith. Man adha zummiyan faqad azani. Whoever hurt, what about killing? Whoever hurt a Christian or a Jew is like hurting me, hurting the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. You got a case, you have to use the other civilized way to address your case and your problem. You know, not in this barbaric way. And unfortunately, TV have been picking up one or two extremists on TV and making things worse. If any non-Muslim watching, he wouldn't like. She wouldn't like. Any non-Muslim, she wouldn't like to know about Islam. He wouldn't like, she wouldn't like to have Muslim next door to her or to him. So we have big problem, my dear brothers and sisters. And I'm raising it, you know, for many reasons, to learn from this incident, to avoid, inshallah, anything like this, and to protect ourselves in this delicate, serious time. You have to protect your mosque. You have to learn. You have to ask the police. You have to protect sister. And as I said, you Muslim woman, Somali, Pakistani, Arabic, niqab, you are a big target today. You have to be very careful, please. If you go, if you have to go, get your husband, your son, your relative, you know, go together, not alone, and especially at night. May Allah guide us and protect us, and may Allah make our Muslim community, as it should be, peace, loving, caring community, working as a British citizen. We're still not living as British citizens. Many of us, apart from this horrible incident. Now, my third announcement, as you know, last Tuesday, we lost again. It was expected. You know, same-sex marriage, gay marriage. As you know, I talk a lot before about this issue, mainly to ask Muslims to write to their member of parliament, MP, tell him, tell her, please vote against sex marriage. Unfortunately, last Tuesday, two-thirds supported same-sex marriage. One-third were against same-sex marriage. So we still have majority against this gay marriage or same-sex marriage. Now, next Monday, it will be in the House of Lords. The only work left for us, and we have a meeting now, Muslim and Christian, trying to do something in the House of Lords to send letter. We're working now on multi-faced letter to go to House of Lords, you know, to Prime Minister David Cameron, to leader of the party, and to send, inshallah, to the every Lord. We have got many hundred people in the House of Lord. Our only hope, we need your dua, by the way. We need your prayer. These people supposed to be more wise, many of them old, in the House of Lord, stop this same-sex marriage. Stop it. If they stop it, it has to go back to Parliament. But if they allow it, we lost for good. Finish. If they allow it. So at least, Muslim, my dear brother and sister, you can see the list of House of Lord. You can get email address. Tell them, you know, write. Pick up any man, any woman, House of Lord. We are citizen. We are a Muslim. We are parent. You know, whatever you like, we ask you. We kindly ask you to not vote for same-sex marriage in the House of Lord. Please. For family reason, for moral reason, for the interest of our children, for the job of our people, for protection of children in school, you know, because teacher will be by law obliged to teach my Muslim son, My Muslim daughter, you can get married to the same boy, same girl. If you are a boy, you marry boy. If you are a girl, you marry girl. And if Muslim teacher did not teach, sacked. Discipline or sacked. You know, this has got very serious implication, my dear brother. So this is left. You know, I gave you before the SPAC website. You will get detail about the Lord, to write of them, or go to Google, search House of Lord. You know, they give you the name, the telephone, the email address. But SPAC.org.uk, SPAC, Society for the Protection of Unborn Children, .org.uk, SPAC, www.spac.org.uk. You see a lot of activity. On top now, House of Lord, same-sex marriage. What can you do? So please, this is now getting critical. Next Monday, we're having a big meeting soon, Muslim and Christian, what to do in the House of Lord. And we're having, you know, even some financial problem, how to pay the expense and letter, etc. And we're trying to look for some donor to help us in this noble campaign, Islamic campaign, to keep the holy marriage as Allah wanted between a man and a woman. Now allow me to the main section, the what we call it latest scientific or medical or health or social study. I have in front of me seven, which came in the last 7 days. Seven report. And as you know, each one, ideally, I should have the whole show to discuss it. Ideally, this is what should be done. But so many, and I have only this 40 minutes or so every week, so I only have to go to the main idea and give you a little flavor about it and sometimes link to Islam, etc. Now, the first of study, medical study, psychological study came today in Daily Mail. Half of women failed to bond with their children. You know, mother, you celebrate, you are having a baby. They discovering this is very serious phenomena and need to be addressed really. And I cannot do it now in this 2-3 minutes for each of this study and report I'm bringing to you. But we need to go to the study, we need to find the cause, we need to learn what is in Islam help to avoid bonding. You know, bonding mean the child in front of you, who is that? No interest. Failure of bonding. No love. No care. You know, like normal, proper mother. She will be, you know, dying to keep her child alive. She do everything to keep her son or her daughter. She will be happy celebrating with the hard work she's doing for the baby. So we're having a new phenomena. I wonder now, there could be so many reasons. Sometimes the difficult births, you know. Episiotomy or cesarean, or they take the child away as they do a lot in hospital, or no breastfeeding. I keep reminding Muslim women and women of the world, the most crucial breastfeeding is the first few days after giving birth to the baby. Medically, to give you colostrum, this yellowish stuff coming from the breast in the beginning. All antibody against virus, bacteria, which affect the child during all his life. I was amazed, as I said before, maybe they discover antibody against poliomyelitis, so you don't need vaccine. And one day I mentioned maybe to study about 800 type related to bacteria and virus. So could be deprivation, breastfeeding after birth, bonding, star, the maternity instinct. And the feeling. And obviously there could be many other reasons. It could be the mother worried. She's going to be stuck at home. They have all this funny attitude to the many liberal women, etc. I will be at home. I lose my job. I lose my figure. And I will be working hard. Or maybe she's pregnant in a haram way. Haram way. And she got a legitimate child. You know, or there could be so many hidden reasons. We need to address it. And to bring back the bonding. Crucial. Child need full-time mother bonding with him, with her, all the time. Very important. Looking after him, her, all the time. Especially in the first 2 years of breastfeeding. First 5 years is very crucial. This is most serious. If the mother neglect, careless, who is this baby? I don't want to look after him. I don't like it, etc. So you need here psychologist, counselor. You need, in fact, to deal with the issue before giving birth. What's the attitude of the mother? There should be some counseling and questionnaire and find out about the reason of pregnancy. And we need also to reduce our mechanization of the births. It's treated like illness. And woman chained, she cannot move, lying back, and, you know, and they have sometimes complication, they have problem related to whether forceps or episiotomy. I think there is a case to go back to natural births, no doubt. But we'll have few cases, you need hospital, you need to check, etc. There is a case because a lot of people feel they hate after to get pregnant. They hate even to sleep with the husband. They hate to have baby anymore. A lot to do with the way they are giving birth in hospital. So bonding is a basic right to the child, innocent. He, she have done nothing. And you have to love, you have to care. And we have first to address the cause. Next study. This is interesting. Again, came today. Obese children after cesarean section. You know, by the way, in the West and in Britain, very, very high rate. You know, cesarean, C-section. The baby at birth, instead of coming off the normal way, they cut the tummy, they bring the baby out from the tummy, instead of coming from down in the normal way. Sometimes it's important. It's life-saving. You need it sometimes. But it has been a lot of medical reports. They do it a lot. And there have been a lot of medical study about side effect, medical problem of children coming out from the tummy. Today, linked to obesity. Before that, about respiratory infection, asthma. Subhanallah, Allah has made it the perfect, normal, safe way. Natural birth. Perfect. And they said today the baby is not touching the bacteria in the genital tract of the woman to come out. So many things mysterious, we don't know. You try to keep it natural way, as I say, as much as you can. But as I said, the overuse, still doctor in Britain, in the West, overuse. World Health Organization has been campaigning against doctors in the West. They use too much cesarean section. And many women say, no, I don't want to go through the pain, giving birth. This is wrong. And we have a lot of analgesic today, if you worry about pain, etc. Pain is natural. And wallahi, you will forget. Ask the mother, anything related to pain when you see your lovely baby in front of you, boy or a girl. Screaming is a sign of life. Crying, don't be upset. This is normal, natural. And if you know the medical fact behind it, you know the heart has got opening, it closed inside to allow the blood to go the normal way. This is the time. And the child cry. Fascinating thing. Always natural way. God's way is perfect, as you know. So this is the second study. The third one, I keep raising it, yesterday in Liverpool. Old man, 79 years old. Attacked by dog, killed by dog. Kelp, dog. Every few days we hear. Killed, attacked, killed. In Britain, we have over 200,000 attack on dogs. And still people are not learning. We have many small girls attacked, killed. They are attacked without killing, and they are attacked, killed. It's rising. This reminds me of the Islamic way. You don't keep dog at home, on your bed, in your kitchen, especially when you have small children. You have to be careful, my dear brothers. You know, dog is najis. You don't touch. If you touch 7 times, you have to wash one with the sand or turab. You know, you need dog, keep it far away. If you have to have, to go in garden, protect them from burglary, far away. Never, ever allow a dog to be near children, especially. Touching, playing with it, never. Is unhealthy, unhygienic, and dangerous. They always say the dog is unpredictable, suddenly go mad and violent. This is a fact of life. You know, I'm worried because I'm discovering more maybe Muslim liberal who don't know about Islam having dog inside the house. You can keep cat, not dog. Remember that. But you have another problem. You may be not keeping dog. Your next door neighbor has got dog, maybe coming to your garden. When you go park, you will see a lot of dog coming around, your children. You need to be doubly careful. The dog, unpredictable, suddenly go wild and attack and kill. 79-year-old, so weak. The dog next door neighbor, now they kill the dog and they take the two neighbor women, or the two women who have got the dog. So we need to be careful, because I'm worried there have been many years back, big story, a little Muslim girl killed by a dog. Anybody could be killed by a dog. And what a beautiful Islamic guidance. No dog. Friendly to you, at home, in kitchen, in your bedroom. He can kill any of your children, small baby, children, you know, and is najis, unhygienic. He can attack, you know. And still the government and people in Britain in denial. They still wait every few days, somebody killed. They are not addressing the cause till now. We have about 8 million dogs. And they're breeding more and more. And they're causing mess on the road. They're causing neighbors to go to court, barking at night. Dog barking, they go to court. You know, the postman running away, he's not putting the letter in the box. Letter box, he's running away. He put his hand, the dog attack, you know. Excreta, parasite. Toxocora canis, famous from the dog. It can cause blindness, can cause epilepsy. You know, convulsion of epilepsy in the brain, it causes blindness. It comes when your child, when any man, woman, child, touch a grass in the park. This grass has got left over from dog excreta. You don't see it sometimes, you know. And you take your finger, your hand, touch something contaminated by dog before on this nice park, etc. And you put your hand, your finger inside your mouth, you swallow. It goes into the system in your body, the parasite from the dog. So Muslim, please be aware. Please avoid, this is not Islamic, to have a dog playing with you, around you in the house, inside the house. And if you have to do it, you do it far, far, far away. At the end of the garden, if you have to do it, you know. And some dogs are used today to detect drugs in the airport. Very good, you know. But some dogs, they use them for the blind. I don't like that, although it's good, you know. But I prefer a human being to hold the blind man, the blind person, to show him around, etc. Not the dog as such, because still the dog could be dangerous on the road. It's unhygienic and could be touching you and touching other, etc. Anyway, this is a sad study. Another study came also in today, and a few days ago I saw it. Birth control make woman masculine. You know birth control? Contraceptive pill. And this is worrying. In fact, we're discovering today a lot of women looking, talking, the voice, the body, the job, they're competing blindly with men. They want to do equality like men. We have a rising number. Did you know? I never forget it. A big report in a woman magazine. They show us women with mustache, with beard, voice like a man. You know, we say men usually domestic violence attack women. We have today a lot of women. Masculine, like a man beating their man, beating their husband. You know, we don't agree with both, obviously, whether man or woman, you know, attacking. So this is a new phenomenon. I believe maybe this hormone thing play a part. You know, this contraceptive hormone has got all estrogen, progesterone, you know. And every one of us has got, you know, man has got more testosterone and a little estrogen. Women have got more estrogen hormone and little testosterone. So this balance created by God is disturbed. When people take hormone, even the hormone for menopause, you know, post-menopause, some people have some funny reaction. They take hormone for many other reasons. This is very delicate substance to use in the human body because they are all imbalanced. And obviously contraceptive pill and birth control, we oppose it mainly because it has opened the door for promiscuity, sleeping around, adultery, fornication. They want to avoid to get pregnant, but they still can get sexually transmitted disease. They don't think about it, you know. They try to avoid pregnancy, you know, and contraceptive pill. So this is an issue we should maybe address it in detail one day and look. What are the symptoms? I was astonished yesterday looking Google and masculinity of women today. So many symptoms. You are not woman anymore. You are half man, half woman. Or you're becoming more like a man, you know, in a lot of attitude, voice, gentleness, sexuality, job, behavior. This is very serious. Allah has made it clear difference, man and woman. And this is a beauty. This is a beauty. Vive la différence, as we always say. And now we have third sex. We have man becoming like woman halfway. We have women becoming like men halfway, etc. There are a lot to be addressed, to be discussed. Maybe one day we'll mention it in a detail, inshallah. Now, this issue of fizzy drink coming again. 7-Up, Fanta, Coca-Cola, Pepsi-Cola. I warned you before, we have clear evidence of alcohol in this, especially some people say even some pork, etc. You have to avoid it completely, my dear brother and sister. In your wedding, in your party, in Ramadan, in mosque, etc. But we're talking today here fizzy drink generally. You know, 7-Up, Fanta, lemonade, etc. Damage the teeth, cause kidney stone. How many people know that? And they have no health benefit at all. And has got high sugar, obesity, overweight. Please, go to natural, freshly squeezed fruit, drink, squeeze at home, or water. My golden medical advice, avoid as much as you can all these things. They come in an attractive container. Your children tempted, you will be tempted. No health benefit, waste of money, disease, damage to the teeth. Cancer, stone in the kidney. This came about 2-3 weeks ago. All these fizzy drink, avoid it. And we are all addicted, Muslim and non-Muslim. And please, I beg you, avoid especially Coca-Cola, Pepsi-Cola. Maybe one day I will bring you to discuss the report published, not by Muslim, by non-Muslim, about the ingredient in Pepsi-Cola, Coca-Cola. And how much high sugar, Coca-Cola, Pepsi-Cola. You know, and no health benefit. Remember that. You are not allowed in Islam to waste money. You are not allowed in Islam to take things has got harm to your health. You are not allowed in Islam to say shubha. If you don't believe me about alcohol or pork, say shubha, controversy. You are not allowed to consume that. Ramadan is coming. Stick to freshly squeezed, could be expensive, I know, but life. Jannah expensive, naturally squeeze orange, carrot, tomato, grape, or water, fresh water. Even the water, I say, you have to be careful, container and plastic. There have been a lot of study, some chemical inside the plastic, which has got the water, leaking, causing cancer. You have to have it fresh water and avoid the water staying in the bottle plastic. Store water, if you like, in other, not plastic, you know, other things, glass, etc. So this is coming a lot, and I hope Muslim will take notice. I hope everybody, not only Muslim, avoid this harmful, you know, big business. No benefit. Another one came, I touched on it before, it came, big study. Soap opera damage children, give you unhealthy life. You know soap? Not the soap we wash. You know the drama, series on television, EastEnders. You know, Hollyoak, Neighbor, and Emmerdale Farm. English addicted to it, and more Asian Muslims, especially women and daughter and girl, addicted to it. They say very harmful to health. They thought only of health, but I have to add to it, as I mentioned to you before, about the issue of haram things. You pick it up from this East End. They talk about three things. High rate of alcohol. People watching, receptive, pick up alcohol. High lack of exercise. You know, when you get addicted, you sit on television, remote control, couch potato, overweight, obesity. When people watch a lot and sit, you know, and they mention also unhealthy eating. Because all the rubbish, junk food, snack, they show it in all these series. Most of the time, not all the time. Occasionally they show some cooking, etc. And I add to it more important thing, you learn about sexual immorality, adultery, lying, domestic violence, cheating, so many things. So please, please, my dear Muslim parent, watch out what your children are watching. And you, watch out. There's a lot of immoral, unhealthy harm coming from watching this English, they call it English way of life, which are affect our children, our attitude, our life. May Allah guide me and guide you to the right path, Sirat Mustaqim. Thank you for watching. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.